A single photo can show so much about the human spirit. And we are thrilled tonight to be joined by one of the great photographers of a generation. He is a Catchlight Global Fellow, a Pulitzer Center grantee. His award-winning work captures human stories across the Americas, stories about migration, culture, and inequality. His latest project, East of Eden, looks at the importance of faith in California's Central Valley, one of the most important agricultural areas of the world with a largely migrant labor force. Brian Frank is joining us tonight. Thank you so much, Brian, for being here with us.
Thanks for having me.
So you look at a number of different communities that really don't get much attention in California, outside of California. What inspired you to dive into this type of storytelling?
I think that what led me to doing this type of work probably is my background. My mom is an immigrant from the Caribbean, and my dad was a union organizer. And so I think all of my work over the last 15 plus years has really looked heavily at labor in one way or another. And, you know, I think a lot of the different themes that I've been interested in, labor, criminal justice, et cetera, kind of all came together in this latest project that I've been working on. You know, I think that it's really important that people know where their food comes from. And I also was hoping that looking at folks whose labor provides that food through this lens of faith, I hope that could be kind of a common bridge for people. I think that this community gets scapegoated quite a bit for the nation's ails. And I hope that, you know, finding common ground is what I always try to do with my work. And, you know, this is a community of very strong faith, and they lean on that faith for strength. And they especially did so during COVID, when they couldn't really rely on the government for help and assistance like many American citizens could. So that was kind of what spurred me to really focus in on this community during that time.
And it's such important work. And we've seen some of those images pop up here on the screen. We can see the stories in that one photo, the tragedy and the joy in some of these pictures. What is the most important thing for you when deciding what projects to take on?
I guess it has to be something that I feel deep inside that I have to do, because, you know, photojournalism is a very tough field. Print has been a hard field to be in for quite a while right now. And so I think for me, if I'm listening to myself, and it's something I have to say, what I have to put into it, what type of investment I have to put in time and capital and time away from my family, if I have to do it, I have to listen to that voice. I've learned over years to follow that voice.
And oftentimes you're in difficult situations. Many photojournalists find themselves in tough situations. They capture important moments that should be seen, but sometimes there are moments that are incredibly intimate, maybe traumatic, maybe even moments that people think should stay private. You clearly have this trust with the folks who you're photographing. How do you balance all of that as a photojournalist?
Oh, there's a lot to balance there. I think it's really important to understand why people migrate to the US. And that often, for me, that has meant documenting very dangerous things, the drug war, et cetera. It's extreme violence that pushes people across the border in the first place. So I have found myself in extremely dangerous places. The way that I've been able to deal with that is, you know, leaning on my colleagues and just trying to, you know, make sure that I do a lot of self-healing when I come back from those types of jobs. I think, you know, it is true. And I think the other part of your question about kind of folks allowing me into intimate spaces, I think it's a matter of I'm there as a conduit for other people. And I think that I'm emotionally invested in people I spend time with. And that isn't something that I can fake. And I think people see that and understand that.
got some beautiful pieces of art. And we encourage everyone to check out Brian's latest work, East of Eden, on his Instagram or his website, brianfrankphoto.com. Thanks, Brian.
Thank you so much.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.